paradigm shift.
An educational comedy.
It's not a cause. Not a movement.
It's not a social group you can slap a label on to.
It's an idea. It's an intention.
It's an intuition.
A mindset in which reality can be explored.
A genuine expression.
Discernment.
Critical thinking and imagination.
To look inward upon ourselves.
To better understand the external world around us.
And yes,
few egos are bound to be bruised.
With our silly, strange, politically incorrect.
Your
style
of going about things.
Real and raw honesty.
Which invites you to be
you to the fullest.
Dealing with like rational people here.
What? At your house, all your TVs, your doomsday room.
Hey, look, come on.
They've strapped explosives to the Capitol.
Like strapped with dynamite.
His broadcast.
When I touched this thing for a few minutes, it felt like anything was possible. So then why can't the opposite happen? What if the monitor is just a giant pin? But instead of making you think positive, it makes you think negative.
Standing in the middle of Times Square at rush hour and saying either you do it my way or we're going to blow you up, ourselves up, and the whole country up with us.
And it's convincing the whole world to feed their own wolf. We need to turn that thing off.
Acting like terror.
Apparently, Dale, you a full-blown terrorist.
The risk that we're especially concerned of right now is the lone wolf terrorist being able to carry out wide-scale massacres of the sort that we saw in Norway recently.
It's been personal, it's been about him, and it's about hatred. We hate you, we want to kill you.
He's taking a possible future and making it
amplifying it, transmitting it, like a feedback loop.
It's a self-fulfilling prophecy that's coming from right there.
Showing people the end of the world, it's giving them the idea over and over and over again, it's accepted.
Bringing entertainment to thousands of people. Through its magic, we are able to enjoy a combination of the radio, motion pictures, and the stage, right in the comfort of our own homes, simply by pushing a button and turning a dial. These cells with their electrical charges are scanned by a stream of electrons, completing 30 pictures a second. Compare that crude picture with these of today, and you can judge for yourself how far along the road to perfection television has traveled.
Most people still today think that all entertainment to do with movies, drama, is therefore nothing more than their entertainment. It never ever was that case.
Of course, television can't perform such miracles as this, yet. But perhaps there's no harm wishing that it could.
The greatest social messages are promoted through movies and drama, high drama, through the fixation of emotive sequences, emotional sequences, not logical, factual sequences, but pushing points across in an emotional way which register and fix in the mind. So emotional content is very, very important, rather than going through an actual discussion or an argument using logic and facts. There's no debate. And when you're being downloaded through fiction, your guard is down, the sensor part of your brain is not in action. It isn't saying, yes, I agree with this, I disagree with that, as you would in a debate or a lecture. You're actually in an alpha state, being completely downloaded with new ideas.
I'm telling you what it's doing. Why don't you care?
It's a magic. If you glimpsed the future, you were frightened by what you saw, what would you do with that information? You would go to the politicians, captains of industry, and how would you convince them? Data, facts, good luck. The only facts they won't challenge are the ones that keep the wheels greased and the dollars rolling in. But what if there was a way of skipping the middleman, putting the critical news directly into everyone's head? The probability of widespread annihilation kept going up. The only way to stop it was to show it, to scare people straight. Because what reasonable human being wouldn't be galvanized by the potential destruction of everything they've ever known or loved? To save civilization, I would show its collapse. How do you think this vision was received? How do you think people responded to the prospect of imminent doom? They gobbled it up. Chocolate éclair. They didn't fear their demise. They repackaged it. It can be enjoyed as video games, as TV shows, books, movies. The entire world wholeheartedly embraced the apocalypse and sprinted towards it with gleeful abandon. Meanwhile, your earth is crumbling all around you. You've got simultaneous epidemics of obesity and starvation. Explain that one. Bees and butterflies start to disappear all around you. Coal mine canaries are dropping dead, and you won't take the hint! In every moment, there is the possibility of a better future. But you people won't believe it. And because you won't believe it, you won't do what is necessary to make it a reality. So you dwell on this terrible future, you resign yourselves to it. For one reason, because that future doesn't ask anything of you today. So, yes, you saw the iceberg, you warned the Titanic. You will just steer for it anyway, full steam ahead. Why? Because you want to sink. You gave up.
Dreamers. We are looking for dreamers. Anyone who will feed the right wolf.
So, go out there and the ones who haven't given up.